Enchanted, Ariel, Gem Mint 10. These are going for pretty good pricing right now. There's only one on eBay. There's zero on TCG Player. There is, I haven't seen any on Facebook. So there's basically just one available, and the seller wants $1,200, $1,200 for this Disney Lorcana Ursula Enchanted Gem Mint PSA 10. Now, just to put that into retrospect, an ungraded version is going to go for about $300, maybe $260 if you're lucky. So you can see the price difference when you get a Gem Mint 10. It's very important to get your cards graded and them to come back as 10s. Now, what can you do to mitigate that? You sleeve it up, you be very careful with it. No white edges, don't be creasing the card, don't be playing with the card, you know, don't be messing around. Once you get this serious card in your hands, if you ever do, if you're lucky to rip this card, I was hoping to get this chase card. It's really difficult to pull this. There's not too many of these examples in the market, and a lot of them are PSA 8s and 9s because they have a lot of whitening and they have lines across the surface of the screen, which sucks. I was lucky to pull the mini, the PSA 10 mini. And you know, we've got a PSA 10 mini mouse Enchanted. I'm the first one to put it onto TCG Player. There's zero on eBay, there's zero on Facebook. I'm actually the first one to put it online, a PSA 10 mini, so that's pretty cool. So I'm the one that has to set the bar. I'm the one that has to say, okay, this is how much it's gonna cost. Because, and then everyone goes off me. They see that I'm selling mine for this, or trying to sell mine for this, and they're gonna try and do the same thing if they have the card, or if they have it graded, ready to go. I got my card many, many weeks ago when the initial launch happened, when the local game stores got their products. I got the products too, versus everyone else who had to wait 2 weeks for the main stores, Walmart, Target, Amazon, to hit. So I got mine substantially earlier, 2 weeks earlier than everybody else, and I pulled it Enchanted, and I sent it out to the graders the next day. And I did expedited shipping, because I wanted that in my hands as soon as possible, so I could take pictures and put it online. I had a couple offers for it. Some guy wanted to trade me for his Pokemon cards. I said, no, I've got enough Pokemon stuff. I need just the cash, or if you want to trade, it's got to be for another Enchanted, and that Enchanted better be worth more, which is not going to be, because all ungraded Enchanteds right now for set 4, chapter 4, the 260, 270, that's the highest it gets. You know, you have to have a graded Enchanted to match your graded Enchanted right now, if they wanted to do an equal trade with me. But yeah, okay, let's talk in more action. Here you go. Look, as you guys can see on your screen, this is the Ariel Enchanted Gem Mint 10 from eBay. $1,200 buy now. It's not even a bid. That's the guy just wants that money, $1,200. Now, just to put this into retrospect again, $260, $270, maybe $300 you can buy the card for raw. Then you get it graded, that's $50. And then you're in the card about, you know, $350, $330 if you get a good deal, which is hard because there's not many examples of this card. And then you can flip it for like 3-4 times the value what you paid for it. But I don't think it's gonna get $1,200. I don't think it's gonna get 1.2K. I think this card is gonna reach about $800. Most people would spend about $500 if it's graded. They would spend, you know, maybe double what the card's worth, maybe $600, double what the card's worth. I don't see anyone reaching out to the $800 if you're for the super ballers, because there's the rich people out there, man, and they just collect everything. They've got millions of dollars and they just love cards. So they're out there. They're far and few, but they're out there. Just like the cards. The cards are far and few, but they are out there on the market. So yeah, it's crazy. But I think this card is gonna sell for most likely $800. He's gonna have to put best offer. So if we make an offer, I don't want to put $800 offer because he didn't have to commit to it. But let's just see if we lowball the guy and see if he accepts it. We'll just go $600, for example. Yeah, he's not gonna accept this. It's not gonna happen. It's not gonna happen. See, look, we'll make the offer. Seller declined your offer right away. See. There's no way it's gonna happen. We could even try $800. We could even try $800. The one I just said, yeah? That's the max you should probably commit to. I'm not even gonna send it, because it might get accepted, who knows? I think this will probably sell for $800. Anyways, if you guys enjoyed this video, let me know in the comment section. If you are trying to get into the grading stuff yourself to grade cards and to sell them, let me know. Or if you are trying to buy graded cards and then sell them at a later date for a lot more, which is a really smart investment, which most people don't do, but there's some people do, and it's a great way to make easy cash, then let me know in the comment section as well. It's not hard to do. Go just drop a comment down. And also, if you enjoyed the information in this video, smash the like button, because it helps me get through the algorithm on YouTube to struggle through the to the top, and then, you know, they can promote it out to more people, so more people can see this video and hear about some information that I have to share. All right, if you are also new, subscribe. It's free to do so. It takes you a second, and it helps me grow, and it helps you find me. See you later. Bye bye.